Yes.
I have no idea what was happening myself, and I actually talked to this guy about that I actually did. And I'm wondering, like, how long should death row be into, like, how many voices?
I recommend, what I did for my demo is I hired somebody, and he kind of coached me through all the slides that we're going to do, and him and the engineer, they chose, because they know what how long it should be and how many voices and what your range is and things like that. So not everybody hires people to like go through that entire process, but that's probably the most easiest way, also the most expensive too, so.
I would say spend the extra money and get a really good sounding demo, because that way you'll sound on the level with, you know, other people who are already doing it professionally.
Yeah, demo's really important. Make sure anyone who wants to get into this industry have one, because I can't tell you how many people starting out is like, oh, I'm taking classes, you know, I'm studying, and this is what I want to do, and I can, and if you've not been in anything yet, and I don't know your voice, and I don't know your ability, I can't recommend you, you know? I mean, I guess I could, but I would not feel comfortable to, and even if I give somebody your name, they don't, if you haven't done anything, they can't go and look you up. You know, if they have credits or something, then they can see, but if you don't, then all that they have to go on is your demo. So it's really, really important to have demo. For me personally, they used to say a demo shouldn't be longer than 2 minutes, but now as things get even like, we have like less and less of attention spans, I would say no longer than like a minute, at most a minute and a half. If you're a minute and a half, you better be very, very awesome and very, very versatile.
Honestly, people will make their decision whether they like your voice in about 3 seconds.
Yeah.
So put your strongest voice first.
Any listeners? Oh yeah, Brenton back there.
Okay, my question is,
did I enjoy recording at Echo 7? Oh yeah, of course, totally. Was there anything? You know, it's so hard. Like for me, I'm so critical that there's always like moments that I would want to redo or do better. But now at this point, it's been so long since we stopped recording at Echo 7 that I can't remember what those specific moments are. But it was definitely, it was really, really enjoyable. That character was really close to my heart because it was 52 episodes, and you don't work on, like, I remember when we were working on that last volume in the last episode, it was weird because I think we'd been recording for like maybe 3 years or it was a long time we were recording.
And then like a couple of years later we did the movie.
Then we did the movie.
It was so like so nostalgic returning.
Yeah, so it was weird to be like, wow, I'm not coming in to do this anymore, or this character, it's a little bit weird, you know? So it definitely has like a really important place in my heart because of that, like spent so much time living with that character.
I'd like to introduce Tony Oliver sitting right over there. He's the writer and the director on the newest stuff for KMS. You want to grab a mic and let me say a few words?
A few words. Thanks. It's been a real privilege to do these shows and the latest one I'm working on is with these guys is K-On. And so I have to be honest, it's a show where I first was told about it. I'm going, a girl high school show about a band. But as I got into it and started writing it, it's been a really great, it's a fun show, and I hope you really enjoy it as it goes through. Aaron, these shows were restricted, didn't you?
Yesterday after possibly shows were restricted.
Yeah, so, and they get better. So that's cool. They're really good at the top, and they get better as they go. So, especially Neil's corner bar problem. So thanks, guys. Thanks very much.
Actually, like, I think 2 minutes, 3 minutes.
Okay, David, go ahead.
What happens if you're going to do channels? Milky Cabbage.
Milky Cabbage was this account that I had when I was really, it was a few years ago. And I posted like dozens of songs that I would do just for fun. And one particular song, it became really, really popular. Caramel Dancing. And unfortunately, this happens when you're doing things like unofficially, that it was just huge. And so the people in Sweden who produced the song, they got really, really angry at me. And so they had me back. And that's basically what happened to that. But now I have rights to a song, an anime song, and it's being produced right now, and that's going to be available like officially, like 100% legit on iTunes. And also another song that's coming out, it's like an original for a game that's coming out soon. So yeah, so now it's kind of just like transitioning to like the official, like this is 100% legit. So I'm still around, just doing more professional things. Yeah, that's going to stay up for the time being, but definitely there's bigger things coming.
Okay, I think we're like out of time. Let's see. Just go over like this Tuesday coming out in the stores. We've got the first DVD and Blu-ray coming out, and then in June 14th, we've got Volume 2 DVD and Blu-ray coming out. And later today at 1:15, we have a mini group performance with the girls singing at the Countdowns. And we'll have a poster giveaway and autograph session. And then again tomorrow at 12:15, the same day, a poster giveaway, autographs, and performance. So I'd like to thank Stephanie Shea, Christina B, Dr. Morris for joining us here on the panel. And thank you for coming to the
You guys, the voice actor panel is next in here, so.